This is the NFL on EA Sports as we join you from Everbank Stadium here in Jacksonville. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars. The kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Jacksonville. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. At their own 23-yard line. Going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Okay, ready? Hey, kill, 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 kill!
Here we go. Lawrence looking to pass on the first play. Open man right side is Ingram. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
On second down, a run with ETN. He's got some space here. And able to get this one across the 45. Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. A short throw to Ingram. So getting 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it's second down. A give, it's ETN off the option. And good work there in open space. He's got this all the way down now to the 32. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Here's Lawrence. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
On second down, here's Lawrence. This is caught, and he's brought down before he reaches the 8-yard line. There we are with ETN. They will get this in the end zone for a drive-by touchdown. Travis ETN, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Jags are on the board first here this afternoon.
Sometimes you get a first and goal, and you're back near the 7, 8, 9-yard line, and you start thinking, maybe we'll run it here on first down to get half of what we need, so maybe we can have 2 or 3 shots at going for it from closer range. So this is a bonus right here. What a great run to work his way into the end zone.
Turn sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 right at the 30. And they'll begin by running the option. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so he didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
Now a second and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. He completes it to Julio Jones. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A nice little game. It's second and 5. And they'll stay on the ground. He'll gain well again. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Second and 7. Give running right is Gainwell. And he takes us just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 yards and a first down for Philly. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game. It's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Second down, here's Hurts. And this is dropped. And
down 7-0 on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a first and 10.
If we get a few more drives like that. We're in the second quarter now, and we've only had one drive apiece, each of which have ended with touchdowns.
Elliott good on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit points.
Gets him 15 and a first down. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter. On first and 10, it's ETN. And some nifty running here as they take this across midfield and down to the 47. Lawrence now going to move him around.
Jaguars, first down.
Think right.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. To the sideline, wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds.
Let's go.
From the 43, here's a second down and 6. Lawrence giving to ETN here on the option. On a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Looks like the offense is going to take another shot here. They're going on fourth and 13.
Dirty left.
And audible here to get a new look.
Hill down.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out. Looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And finally, just a lot of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Second and 10. On the option right. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Philadelphia. What a run there by Jalen Hurts. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Elliott on for the extra point. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Eagles 14, Jaguars 7. Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Jaguars take over.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived, as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by seven.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
And they'll bring four receivers into the fold here. It's third and long. From the gun, it's Lawrence. Just shy of the 30. A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth.
13, Luke. Luke. Hey, I'm gone. Gun.
Hot. And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. And they'll find the open man. That's complete. Decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. I don't know if I agree with that, but I guess they don't care if I agree with that. Boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation, but they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on, or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
And get what he can off the middle at 3 yards. That'll bring up second down. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout, as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Red on red.
And they'll come up second and 7.
Same right.
Lawrence going to fire it out wide, complete. Now the Jags will use use the second of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six.
Think right open, open. 11, add it.
Here we go. Lawrence. He's got his target. That's complete. Boy, he's out of bounds inside the 35. The play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. Really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
Back to the ground with ETN. That's a strong running there as he's down just short of the 20 on the edge of the end zone.
Hey, Jupiter.
First down now, but that clock rolling. They go play action with Lawrence.
Secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you got a brand new ball game. McManus's point after is good, and that is going to tie up the game as we approach halftime. So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for a really fun second half because we're seeing both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But I'm a defensive player. Thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. This is caught. It's caught. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
But first down, Hurts. That's caught by the big this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Throwing is Hurts. Have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and the lead is now 21-14. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down seven following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now, they're really starting to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Thank you. already at the line. This Philly offense set to go. We got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown. So every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. And here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an out boy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. To the left there, complete to the tight end, got it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Second and one.
Brings up second and a yard.
And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Just need a yard here, second and one. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And a pretty athletic run right there as he's going to get this down inside the 40. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that's an incredible ball. It comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football for triple option, you've actually called that play.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup. Taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
Hurts. And this one complete to Smith. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. On third down, it's game one. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Kenneth Gainwell with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Elliott now to add the extra point. And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game.
Jaguars 21. Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They now trail by seven after that last touchdown here in the fourth quarter. What a big spot for this offense. See if they can cobble something together on this drive.
And the offense moving quickly to the line.
That's good. Jaguars.
On first down, Lawrence.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And again, down, but not before it takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down. Here's ETN. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient. Followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Hey, kill, kill! Kill, kill!
On second down, here's Lawrence. A short throw to Ingram. And he has another first down as they get the ball down to the Eagles 36. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. A give, it's ETN off the option. And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. 111 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try to snatch a victory.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Second and six coming up. Lawrence with a quick throw outside. That's complete. And now third down.
Run.
A gain of two on the play. Brings up third and four.
And complete this to Ingram's tight end. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line.
Oh, I know it goes against the grain here. It totally goes against it, but you've got to drop the ball in that situation. He makes the catch, but he loses yards and doesn't get out of bounds.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
11.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
11. 13, Luke.
Here we go. Got to have it. Lawrence.
Stopped to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
ETN, he is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. Second down, goal to go.
At the 5-yard line.
Hey, I'm gone. Here we go.
Here's Lawrence. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play. Third and goal.
Jupiter! Here we go.
And he's got kick this one away. And a fair catch taken. No time will come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. They'll come up first and 10 here.
Because remember, they were down to their final chance to retake the lead. That home field advantage, I think it helped fuel all of what happened for them down this.